Namaste YouTube, welcome to Enoma. We are going to give our reaction to Different Strengths by Rush.
It's the first time single take honest reaction. It is a Patreon request and we are really, really happy with the tremendous response we are receiving on Patreon. And most of these offers are going and we are really happy about that. Let's get started with Different Strengths. It's a lyric video. And it's the first time that I'm listening to this song and you too. Let's get
Thanks
started.
Thanks for all the support that you're showering on us and it does matter. Yeah.
And the finished lyric video that you will see is not the one that we are reacting to. So just keep in mind, it will be the same timing and everything, but it will be different. So keep that in mind due to copyright policies.
Come to slay the dragon, come to watch him fall, making arrows out of pointed words, giant killers at the call. Too much fuss and bother, too much contradiction and conclusion.
It was very soothing, a slow one by Rush, very soothing. I like the tempo of the song.
What did you like in the lyrics or this music? What in particular?
I kind of, you know, everything was pretty, the pace was slow, and that was the best part of this whole composition, because the song, you know, talks about different strings. It is different strings, how people are from different places, different different feels we get. Something's click with you, something's click with me. You know, it cannot be always the same things that we may like or we may dislike, or things we enjoy doing. But it's about how different things are, but still we come together at the same time.
Yeah, it's a beautiful piece about relationships, and it's quite common. You often see, not just as a counselor, but a relationship counselor, but I've often seen that, you know, there are such contradictions and differences, and like you said, there are different likes that the couple has, there are different likes that loved ones have. They might be liking something that you don't like even. And how do you find a midway?
Yeah.
How do you come to an agreement?
I like the line.
Who's going to agree with what they disagree with?
The heart beats, you know, for different things. It's yours sometimes for different. It's exactly when that line came, it was like rush reactions. Sometimes a song that clicks a lot with you and I'm okay, it was okay. And sometimes a song really hits me harder and you say this was not as fabulous as some other song. So it was as that. It yeah. was different.
Yeah, and we come in from a part of the world where there are so many different people. There are 1.3 or 4 billion people now.
Yeah.
In just our country, 1/5 of the world practically lives
yeah.
in our country, and another 1/5 of them live in a neighboring country,
yeah.
China. So we come from that part of the world where there are different people living, people who eat different foods, wear different clothes, celebrate different festivals, do different things, live and believe in different faiths, speak different languages. And this is a song that will connect with all of them, because inter-caste, inter-racial, inter-community marriages are very, very common in this part of the world. And it's beautiful that we get along.
We do.
We get along so well. You often see, I mean, a prime example of that is we both.
Yes.
I'm a Roman Catholic. She is a Hindu. She is from another part of the country, north. I'm from the west part. We are from different parts. We have different upbringings, different taste in music, food.
Everything. Lifestyle.
Yeah. And it's incredible, because we that's what makes our son's life and our children's life more beautiful, because you get the best of both worlds. And that is what relationships are all about. It's about different people at times. And you'll never get two people who are completely the same. Never. Even twin brothers, scientifically, it is not possible. Genetically, it's not possible. So you can never get even twins being exactly the same. They will have different personalities. Even if they look the same physically on the outside, internally as well as personality-wise, they are completely different, or they have some major differences.
Most times the yeah. differences may not be even physical, but emotion-wise. Some are tougher, some are very mild, you know, softer. Even with twins, one of them is generally a stronger
yeah.
one of them is a milder one who protects the other one.
And
so it's...
Yeah, very recently I met up with a friend of mine. We had a reunion after 25 years. And there was a, you know, very recently I met them, and there was a friend of mine who actually had twins. He's from New Zealand, and you know, he brought his twin sons with him, and they didn't even look alike, to be honest.
Wow.
We couldn't tell that they were twins, and both of them are completely different. One is more docile, calm, or what I gathered from the few hours we spent together. We had dinner in town and we hanged around for a long, long time at the Gateway and Taj. So I gather that one is docile, calm, very, you know, discreet, doesn't like to talk too much. The other was very bold, very frank, was very curt, even a bit rude to some of us, not courteous like the other brother. So it was difficult to tell. They were poles apart. And then, of course, in relationships, this song, I think, mainly deals with relationships, you know. Apart from the first verse where it is more poetic, and I'm sure it may be an inspiration from some great poet of the past. But apart from that, everything else was about a relationship, about a couple, about partners who had their differences, and this song was about them.
Yes. It's actually not odd at all when people are different, when people think differently, when people do things in a different way, when they feel differently. For the same thing, you might not feel the same way. It's not odd at all. It says, who's come to slay the dragon, come to watch him fall, making arrows out of pointed words, giant killers at the call.
What about that? Because we can't show these lyrics on the screen again.
I liked the pointed words. You know, at times we don't need weapons in human world. At times, in relationships, we can kill a person only with those words. It is more hard hitting, you know. In our families, at times, you know, children complain that your words are worse than anything else. A slap would have been okay, but those words really hurt me a lot. And in relationships too, you know, the things we do or the things we may have said once that hurts a person for a long, long time, then a wound, an actual wound that may have.
Actual slap even.
Yeah.
Or a hit on the back of the head.
Caused.
Your emotional wounds always hurt.
And they mostly come through those more. Harsh words.
Harsh words as well as arguments, fights, disagreements. You know, and ignorance. Ignorance in relationships because of differences. There's a lot of ignorance in today's world.
It is.
You know, we just ignore our loved ones, our partners at times. And that is very sad. That is the worst thing about relationships that I've seen in my experience, not just as a counselor, but even in families and even in relationships, even in my own family and friend circle. You know, just because we are different, we ignore each other. You know, we may meet up and we will only talk maximum to a particular person because that person is more like you or has the same background as you or career interest. And how sad is that in the world of today? Because you ignore the other friend who you spent a lot of time with earlier, but now just because they are from a different economical background or career profile, you just suddenly ignore them. You meet up with them as if you're doing a favor. And it happens in relationships too. Many, many times, I can't tell you the number of times I've had clients come into me for family counseling or couples therapy where they just didn't spend time with each other. They would just ignore each other. I remember the story which I've shared, Rekha, little Rekha, where actually, it's based on a true story of mine in my own life. The little girl in the story did not spend time with her father for 2 months. In fact, she hadn't seen her father for 2 weeks or more. And she was only living alone with her father. Her mother had passed away and she gave birth to her, to Rekha. So there are so many instances like that. Today in the world, we hardly spend quality time with each other. And Rush has written something which they may even not know how relevant it is today.
Yeah.
Because the world has changed so much. It is even more ignorant, even more silly, even more queer, even more differences thrown on the plate. So you have more and more differences. And because of those differences in relationships, friendships, families, workplace, people just ignore each other. They think ignorance is bliss. So they just brush things under the carpet and hope that someone down there will take care of it someday magically. So when they lift up the carpet after a few years, it will be magically done. Without any dust, without any dirt, without any moisture, without anything. So we live our lives. So many of us live our lives. I can't tell you how many people I've dealt with or counseled who come into this category, where they think ignorance is the best way out. Not spending time with each other is the best way out. So they literally do anything. How do we get into addictions? As a psychotherapist and counselor, we generally get into addictions because we want to avoid or ignore someone or something.
They don't want to face it.
Yeah, so we, after work, instead of going back home and spending time with our partners, we stay at someone else's place. We have another affair. We go to a local bar. We go to the club. We go to the gym. Or we just hang around outside and come home much later. Or we work harder. So we have workaholics all over the world. We just don't want to come back home and spend quality time with our kids and loved ones. So we live in a really, really crazy, queer, silly, ignorant world right now, where most of the population of the world is not willing to face their differences, not willing to find a way out. What are your final thoughts, Kirti?
I really like the song goes in such a flow that, you know, they first talk about the problems that happen, the arguments and the fuss and so much resistance on both the sides because of the differences. But at the same time, you can come together when you realize that two different people but can make one thing, one piece. It can be different, but it's not difficult.
It's not difficult at all, and that is my moral. That is my moral of this reaction, that no matter how different you are, if you are connected to each other by work or studies or blood, please, or any other way, if you have a connection, you live close to each other and you've been friends or your neighbors, please break bread together, like it says in the Bible. Please find middle ground. Don't ignore each other. Don't put people down. I can't tell you, I met up with a lot of friends this weekend, and everyone was putting other friends down, other people down, their own family members down. I mean, we need to stop this craziness that is going on. It happens in politics. It happens in business. But please don't pull that into your personal life. Please, please don't. It will mess up the world even more. And that's one thing I do not like about social media as it stands today. I dislike the fact that we have the dislike option. I dislike the fact that we go by numbers. We go by what people do or don't do. I dislike the fact that we go by differences rather than we go by the connections that we already have. Wow. I mean, this is really a good song.
You know, so many different strings are there on a guitar.
Thanks a lot to the Patreon to ask us, request for this. It's our very first Patreon once again, and we have almost done with her request, and it's a great, great reaction to end her request almost. So it's really, really good.
I like a taste though, because all the songs that she recommended have been...
And you know, after doing these reactions, I go and see immediately other reactions of the same song, because I don't do it earlier, because I wanted to be honest and sincere on my part, and she doesn't bother anyway. So after I put on the reaction, or after we either of us publish it or schedule it, after it's online, we go and see other reactions. So to see, you know, how did they do? Because we are really, really interested. And sadly, Rush is one of the rock bands in our career as reaction, you know, long reactors on this platform for 16 months is a very, 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 very long time on YouTube.
For a reactor.
Yeah, for a reactor, because most of them stop along the way, takes breaks, long breaks, some vanish, some pass away, some, you know, literally we don't know what has happened to them, and most stop because of so many guidelines and policies and restrictions in their own life and on the platform. So I'm amazed that Rush has probably, in my experience of 16 months, the least number of reactions on YouTube. How sad is that?
Maybe because they are different, so most people don't want to accept. It's just ignore them.
Yeah, that's it. Take the easy way out. We can't talk in detail like these guys on Enoma, the native outsiders in Enoma. So let's take the easy way out. Let's just not react to them. Exactly. Or if we do, if there's a request or if people are begging us to react to something, let us react to only the popular ones and get a lot of views. How cool is that? And even the popular ones, let's just fake our reactions. Let's just pretend we are enjoying it when we aren't. Because any body language expert out there can easily tell when someone is faking it, and we do too. So that's why I'm really, really interested in watching other reactions. And I'm really sad that there's so much difference in the world that people just don't have the time or do not want to even dig deeper into anything new or anything that's different from their usual routine or usual work. It's sad. And that's why I love what I do, because I'm exactly the opposite. And it's not that I hate those reactors. I don't hate them. I still go and watch them. I still watch the other reactions they do. If they're not reacting to Rush, I want to know what else they are reacting to. Because perhaps I'll get some new music to listen to or think of new things to add to my collection. So anyway, it's sad, but at the same time, it's great for me that I and you and the others on Team Enoma are the few fortunate, blessed ones to literally get requests for such great music.
I love, people should learn to embrace the differences in any form, anything. You know, the people can be from different races, people can be of different color, people can be from different backgrounds, people can be of your own race, own color, but can think differently, can be different. You have to embrace them, you have to like them the way they are. Everybody being the same is not the solution. And in relationships, they always say that, there are no two perfect people. It's the two imperfect people who can make a perfect relationship.
Yeah. Just before I end, I should end with what she just said. But I have something a bit more to add to. Just 2 days ago, I was watching a program on Nazi Germany. And I must whisper it now, perhaps. So I saw a photograph on that show, the documentary show. Mm-hmm. I saw one photograph that brought tears to my eyes. It was the millions of shoes of all the ones killed brutally during that time. And I think we need to end this reaction with a little prayer for their families, their grandchildren, their great-grandchildren who are still surviving today, if they are surviving. A little prayer for all of those victims because of a difference of beliefs and opinion. That is all it took to create that photograph of all those piles of shoes of people brutally massacred, killed, poisoned, burned in that era. Goodbye.